हेलो फ्रेंड्स, वंस अगेन वी बिगिन विद द सिलेबस ऑफ फिजिक्स चैप्टर ऑफ करंट इलेक्ट्रिसिटी इन विच वी बिगिन विद द फर्स्ट टॉपिक एज अ किरचॉफ लॉज. सो बिफोर दैट वी हैव ऑलरेडी लर्न इन प्रीवियस स्टैंडर्ड अबाउट द सेम चैप्टर ऑफ करंट इलेक्ट्रिसिटी. सो इन दैट वी हैव डिस्टिंग्विश बिटवीन द conductors, insulators and semiconductors and superconductors. And then we have discussed about the concept of resistance. So resistance, if we define, there is opposition to the flow of charge or opposition to the flow of charge carriers inside a conductor. So that already we have learned in previous standards. Now we have the next part of the same chapter of current electricity that already we have learned in 11th also and 9th, 10th also. But in 12th also, we have the same chapter of current electricity. In that chapter, we have the next syllabus. So before going to start with the actual syllabus, we have first distinguished the type of conductors or types of substances. So let us check the presentation. हाँ, चेक दी चैप्टर नंबर 9th करंट इलेक्ट्रिसिटी. नाउ यू कैन रिकॉल व्हाट वी हैव गिवन हियर इन फर्स्ट सेंटेंस. देयर कैन बी थ्री टाइप्स ऑफ इलेक्ट्रिकल कंडक्टर्स एज अ गुड कंडक्टर्स, फॉर एग्जांपल मेटल्स, सेमी कंडक्टर्स, फॉर एग्जांपल जर्मेनियम एंड सिलिकॉन, एंड बैड कंडक्टर्स और वी कैन से इंसुलेटर, फॉर एग्जांपल रबर, वुड, ग्लास एक्सेट्रा. So that already we have learned in previous standard. Also in 11th standard, we have studied the origin of electrical conductivity in particular for metals. We have also studied how to calculate effective resistance of two or more resistance in series and in parallel. Means we have studied the resistance in series as well as resistance in parallel. Now we actually begin with the 12th standard. And the first topic is the Kirchhoff law of electrical network. So before going to define or state the Kirchhoff laws, we have few definitions. So these will be the electrical network. So already you know the symbol of battery, resistance and all other component symbols. So here we have given certain potential difference with the help of positive and negative terminals of battery. Now we have number of resistors R1, R2, R3, R4, R5, R6, R7, R8. Now in this circuit, we have three definitions. So we have the first point is of a junction. So how to define junction? So check the diagram. We have this point as a junction. And that point can be defined as any point in electrical circuit where two or more conductors are joined together is a junction. So here we have resistance R1, R3 and R2 interconnected at this point, and that point is called junction. So already we know the example of the station and junction in case of railways. So railway junction and railway station. So for station we have one incoming line, and that line will go as outgoing line like this. So there are only two lines, incoming and outgoing. That particular point is called station, railway station. And if we have three lines connected at single point, first, second, third, or more than three lines, that point is called junction. And in case of railways, we have that railway junction. So similarly, in electrical network also, the point which has more than three connections, that point is called junction. Now similarly, we have the next definition is of loop. Any close conducting path in electrical network is called a loop or mesh. So this will be the close path. So we begin with any one of the junction point, and go through resistance R5, R6, R7, and then we complete and again reach the same point. So that complete loop or this particular closed path is called loop in electrical network. So we begin with one point and again come back to the same point. That particular closed path is called loop here. Now the third definition is of a branch. A branch is any part of network that lies between two junctions. So here we have one point as a junction, a second junction, and in between them we have one particular resistor R3, and that particular portion is called branch. So between two junctions we have the branch. So based on these particular definitions we have the actual statement of Kirchhoff's law. Now in this slide we have the Kirchhoff's first law. That law also called as the junction law or the current law or junction law. So what is the statement of this law is the algebraic sum of currents at junction is zero. Algebraic sum means addition of currents at junction point is zero in an electrical network. So we can write mathematically summation I is equal to 1 to n II is equal to 0. So number of currents that is meet at junction, that summation or addition of all the currents, that addition will be equivalent to 0. So before that we have the sign convention, how to use that Kirchhoff's first law. So which sign we have to take for incoming current and outgoing current, that sign convention is given in this particular section of sign convention. The current arriving at the junction are considered positive. The current arriving at junction means the current direction towards the point P or junction point P, that current are taken as positive, and current leaving the junction are considered negative. Current moving away from the junction, direction of current moving away, that will be taken as negative. Now check this diagram. Current I1 flowing toward junction point P, then I2 moving away, I3 will be moving towards, then I4 again moving towards, I5 moving away, and I6 again moving away from the junction. And all these currents we have to add by using the sign convention. We have the equation for the summation as in the next slide. So when we apply the sign convention, so we have taken I1, check the circuit once again, or the junction point P, I1 taken as positive, then I4 taken as positive, and I3 taken as positive. I1, I3, and I4 taken as positive. So I1, I3 and I4, these three currents are taken as positive. Again we check the negative sign. So I2 moving away taken as negative, I5 and I6, these three currents will be taken as negative in this equation. So I1, I3, I4 positive, as these currents are moving towards the junction, and I2, I5, I6 moving away from junction, so that they are taken as the negative here. On addition of all these currents, that will be equivalent to zero. So this is our equation number first. Now arriving currents, again we have given same description here. Arriving current I1, I3, I4 are considered positive, and leaving current I2, I5, I6 are considered negative. Now rearranging this equation, if we send I2, I5 and I6 toward right hand side, so these currents will be taken as positive on right hand side. So I1 plus I5 plus I6. So we balance the equation. Some currents are taken as positive while other negative, that negative become positive on another side. That is equation number 2. Now we have conclusion from equation 2. Thus the total current flowing towards junction is equal to total current flowing away from junction. Total current flowing towards junction that is equal to total current flowing away from junction, and from that we have the Kirchhoff first law is consistent with the conservation of electrical charge. Charge moving toward junction, that much amount of charge moving away from junction. So that first law explains the conservation of charge. So this is first law. Now we begin with the second law. Check the second law, Kirchhoff second law, or we have the voltage law or loop law. Now what is statement here? Check the statement. The algebraic sum of potential difference. Potential difference means product of current and resistance. V is equal to IR. Voltage as a potential difference V, that is equal to I into R according to Ohm's law. So potential difference is product of current and resistance. And the electromotive force, that is EMF. So EMF is of cell or battery or any electrical source that has electromotive force, or in short we have EMF. In a closed loop is zero. So we have two quantities, summation of potential difference. Potential difference is V is equal to IR. So here we taken as I into R, summation of IR plus summation of EMF E, that will be equivalent to zero. So that this will be the second law and corresponding mathematical equation or form. And again, this law, second law, is consistent with the conservation of energy here. So conservation of energy means total energy remain constant. So that law will be satisfy the conservation of energy here. And let us understood the concept of the second law with the help of example. And before that, we have the sign conventions. Again, we have two sign conventions. So first sign convention, check carefully. While tracing a loop through a resistor, if we are traveling along direction of conventional current, the potential difference across that resistance is considered negative. Now check again with the highlighted red color. Along the direction of conventional current, when we are traveling along direction of current, and in that case potential difference across the resistor, in that case the potential difference across resistance is considered as negative. Direction of traveling and potential difference across that particular resistor is taken as negative. Direction of current and direction of traveling, if it's same, then the potential difference taken as negative here. And exactly opposite, if the loop is traced against the direction of conventional current, loop is traced against means opposite direction to the direction of current. We are traveling along one direction, in that direction current is traveling in opposite direction. So in that case, direction of current and traveling, if it is opposite direction, then potential difference across that resistor is considered positive. So this is first sign convention. Now we have second sign convention, the EMF of electrical source. Now second sign convention is for EMF. EMF of electrical source is taken as positive while tracing the loop within the source from negative terminal to negative terminal of the source to its positive terminal. So when we are traveling along the circuit, when we traveling along circuit, first we come across negative terminal and then we jump to the positive through the cell. Then negative to positive, if we take jump, then second terminal is positive here. That case we take an EMF as positive. And exactly opposite, it is taken as negative. So EMF is taken as negative while tracing within the source from positive terminal to negative terminal. When we come across the positive terminal and then negative terminal, so second terminal is negative, so EMF is taken as negative here. So that sign conventions we are going to understood with the help of diagram here. Now check again the circuit diagram. We have the EMF of cell E1 positive and negative in circuit diagram. Then we begin with point A, first resistor is R1, corresponding current is I1. Then point B, we have a resistance R2, direction of current I2, and C, then again C to D, we have EMF E2 cell having F E2, then D2 F again resistor R4 I2, then F2 G current I1 and resistor resistance R3, and in between B and F we have resistance R5 and corresponding current is I3 here. Now let us begin with the sign convention. So first sign convention is when we are traveling from suppose A to B, so A terminal to B terminal or A junction point to B junction point, so current I1 is in a direction from A to B and we have potential difference across R1. Potential difference has formula V is equal to IR according to Ohm's law. So potential difference across R1 is taken as I1 R1. So that I1 R1 potential difference, that will be taken as negative because the direction of current and we traveling from A to B is same. So potential difference as I1 R1 taken as negative here. Similarly, for point B to C, suppose if we traveling from B to C, then in that case the current will be traveling opposite direction. We are traveling from B to C, suppose in that case the potential difference is taken as positive. So suppose if we traveling from B to C, direction of current will be opposite, and in that case potential across R2 will be I2 R2, that potential difference is taken as positive here. Direction opposite, positive here. Now we consider one of the loop. So here we have first loop as A B F G A. For that loop we have to apply the Kirchhoff voltage law, and the direction of loop will be in clockwise direction from A to B, B to F, F to G and G to A. So already we have given the arrow here. So in that case, if you apply the sign conventions to equation 1 will be the summation of IR plus summation of E is equal to 0 here. So now we begin with the first part. So we go from A to B, the component will be resistance R1 and its potential is taken as I1 and R1. So I1 R1 and the direction of current is suppose same from A to B, we are traveling from A to B and also direction is same. So we taken as a negative sign here. So minus I1 R1 is the potential across R1. Then we have second terminal, second branch B to F, and from B to F direction of current will be in downward direction. So we traveling from B to F and also the direction of current is also same I3, and corresponding resistance is R5. So potential across R5 is resistance into current, resistance into current. So R5 into R3 or I3 into R5, and we traveling along same direction as direction of current, so we taken as negative. So see the second equation, first and second particular step, I3 R5, again we taken as negative here. Now we begin with F to G. Now we are traveling from F to G, direction again same. So potential difference across R3 is I1 R3, and that is again taken as negative. So minus I1 R3, potential difference according to Ohm's law, I into R, current I1 and resistance is R3. So that will be again taken as negative. So minus I1 R3, and then we have the next point G to A. So from G to A we have the cell having EMF epsilon 1 or E1. Now we jump from negative terminal to positive terminal inside the cell. So G to A we came across first negative terminal and then we jump to the positive terminal. So second terminal is positive here. So because of that the sign for EMF E1 is taken as positive in equation. So check this equation, plus E1 here because we jump from negative terminal to positive terminal. So first terminal is negative, then we jump on positive. So sign for EMF E1 is taken as positive. So plus E1 is equal to 0 here. So this is about the first loop. Now we rearrange this equation. So all these negative terms, so minus R1 I1 R1 minus I3 R5, minus I1 R3, all these three terms taken on right hand side of this equal to sign, that all sign become positive, and we write equation for E1 is equal to I1 R1 plus I3 R5 plus I1 R3 as the equation for this first loop. Now we have this similarly second loop. So for second loop, you can also calculate, or you can also write the equation. So loop we consider BF, BFDCB, BFDCB in clockwise sense. So this equation is E2 is equal to, again, E2 is equal to, first terminal is, first branch is I3 R5, and direction of traveling or tracing same as direction of current. So we have minus I3 R5. So minus I3 R5, then again direction of current and traveling same, I2 R4, again minus, then negative terminal of cell and jump on positive. So we taken as positive E2, and then again from C to B, we have direction same as the direction of current, I2 R2, potential difference. So that we write here is as the E2 is equal to I2 R2. So we rearrange this term, all the negative sign will be taken as positive on right hand side. So similar to the this equation, we have equation for E2 is equal to I2 R2. So this will be taken as positive on right hand side, plus I3 R5. I3 R5 again positive on right hand side, and I2 R4, I2 R4, that will be again positive. So this is for the second loop of BFDCB, like this. So before going to start with the first and second law, you should know the sign conventions, and then we have the equations, how to design the equations. So these will be the important part for the further syllabus. So try on repeating these steps of understanding. So first of all, once again, we have the current law, then statement, sign convention, and we apply for the circuit diagram or junction point P. Similarly, for the Kirchhoff voltage law or second law, we have the statement, this mathematical form, and the corresponding sign conventions. Sign conventions are of two parts. First is for potential difference, and second part is of EMF. And we have highlight this particular portion so that you can easily remember the signs here, positive, negative, and corresponding circuit we have taken as an example. And for that example, we have solved the particular two equations for two loops. Similarly, at home, you can apply the Kirchhoff law for the loop A, B, C, D, F, G, A for the complete loop like this. So in that case, we have the third types of third equation for loop. Suppose if you consider the loop A, B, C, D, F, G, and A, similarly, we can apply the steps here. And we have the third type of third equation for third loop here. So you can check first two loops, and you can try the third loop similarly here. Okay. See here. So for this chapter of current electricity, you should know the concept of Kirchhoff law as Kirchhoff first law and second law, or current law or voltage law. You go through that law statement and corresponding sign conventions, and go through your textbook and try to write down the equations by that particular circuit diagram. So draw circuit diagram, then try to write the equations as we have explained here. So when you are able to write the equations, then we are able to apply that particular current law and voltage law to the next topic of Wheaton bridge. And that Wheaton bridge has a number of application in this chapter. There's a total new syllabus of standard 12th, or that is not the repetition of 11th standard. So total new syllabus of the concept of the Wheaton bridge and Wheaton meter bridge and potentiometer. So all these further topics depend upon the Kirchhoff laws here. So you should know first the how to apply the current law as well as voltage law, and what are their sign conventions. Sign convention is important part. Otherwise, what happens, you have the confusion in that sign convention. So the equation may be wrong here. So you should try out that particular steps and try to write the equation for circuit diagram here. Okay. So in next lecture, we begin with the topic of Wheaton bridge here. Thank you.